Butler with Student Startup. We're just going to be reviewing some laborer best practices for mowing. Here are a few rules for providing first-class service. The first one is to keep your word. Show up consistently when you say you will. Communicate if something expected comes up, but this should be rare. Most customers pay you so they don't have to think about their mowing. Make sure your service is as convenient as possible. Make it a goal to have yards done before 7 so you aren't interrupting a customer's evening. Walk the property, both before to pick up trash and debris and after to double check to make sure you've provided first class trimming, mowing, edging, and blowing every time. Make sure all gates are closed and ask yourself, what could I do to take this job from pretty good to first class? You want to mow at the right height. Pick the correct height, start at the highest setting, because just like with hair, you can always take off more, but you can't add any. Switch directions every 2 to 3 weeks. About the height. A lot of times, nice fescue lawns, if you don't know what fescue is, look that up, need to be at 5 or 4. And then weeds typically are at level 3. But like I said, when in doubt, always have it higher. Trimming and outlining objects. Trimming should be the same height as the regular mowing. The best way to become proficient is to go out to an open field or ditch and get after it. Get reps and learn your machine. Follow up customer check. The first time you do a job, have the customer check the job with you to make sure it's been done and to see if you can do anything better. To move you from good to first class. If they aren't home, call, or better yet, take a short video and send it to them. The next rule is to keep a calendar. Keep a detailed calendar for all of your jobs. Having an accurate calendar will help you to bill your customers accurately for the work you did and avoid billing mistakes that inconvenience your customer and yourself. Keeping a detailed calendar will also help you keep from losing track of what lawns need to be mowed and forgetting to mow a lawn altogether. Things to avoid. Don't mow soft and wet ground. If it's wet, don't mow. If it's an emergency, only use a push mower since it's less likely to tear up the ground. The worst thing you can do is mow a wet yard with a riding lawnmower and leave ruts. You can also send rocks and flying into windows and breaking them. Do not trim paved areas with weeds and loose gravel. Rocks can fly up and break windows very easily, causing expensive damage. Mowing without your glasses. Always wear some sort of safety glasses when working, especially when trimming and edging. Keep an extra pair in your car just in case. Your business is not worth losing an eye. Stop your mower, trimmer, or edger if other people are nearby. When someone is walking on the sidewalk, be courteous and stop to let them pass by. Flying rocks can severely hurt children and adults. Getting dehydrated. Dehydration can kill, so always have enough cool water to drink. You can bring a cooler full of water bottles and ice. You can also use an insulated metal water bottle. On especially hot days, use a wet bandana or cloth on the neck to keep yourself cool. Another thing to avoid, leaving the gate open. Be sure to close all gates and put hoses back when you are done. Failing to do this may allow your customer's dog to get loose. It also looks much nicer when you leave everything the way you found it, including the gate. Avoid parking on the driveway. Be sure not to park in the driveway if at all possible. This is the polite thing to do, and will also allow them to pull their car out if they are needing to leave the house while you are still at their property. So this is just a review of best practices for a laborer. This is just a summary, so look at the handbook to go a little bit more in depth on this topic. Thanks for watching.